upon the schooner Pickle, new orders I received to make full haste to England from Trafalgar's blooded seas. No time for us to count the cost, nor for recovery. We set the prow nor'westwards, and we pray to God for speed. A mighty victory had been won through Nelson's daring plan to strike the French across their bows so their guns could little aim. We brought them crashing to their knees, those left had cut and run, no more to threaten England with their powder and their guns. We brought the news to Falmouth, then inland from the sea, from Bodmin on to Launceston, with London calling me. After 37 hours hard ride, I reached the Admiralty with tidings of both joy and tragedy. But in the hour of triumph, our Lord Nelson slumped and fell, brought low by a musket ball from the rigging I heard tell. It ripped down through his shoulder, and it lodged hard in his spine. The end had come so cruelly for this faithful Englishman. So we brought the news to Falmouth, then inland from the sea, from Bodmin on to Launceston, with London calling me. After 37 hours hard ride, I reached the Admiralty with tidings of both joy and tragedy. Six and 60 and 200 miles I had to go, with 19 stops to change the team when they could no longer pull. When finally I reached my goal, I found a fate quite rare. For now the history books will know La Penotiere, who brought the news to Falmouth, then inland from the sea, from Bodmin on to Launceston, with London calling me. After 37 hours hard ride, I reached the Admiralty with tidings of both joy and tragedy. We brought the news to Falmouth, then inland from the sea, through Bodmin on to Launceston, with London calling me. After 37 hours hard ride, I reached the Admiralty with tidings of both joy and tragedy.